Hey everyone. I've been doing a lot of audio projects recently, and for audio input, I've settled on using I2S MEMS microphones. Now, these are great devices that you interface directly to your microcontroller without needing any analog to digital converters. The breakout board that I've mostly been using has been based around the INMP441 microphone, and although there seem to be plenty of these boards available, the actual microphone is no longer manufactured and is not recommended for new designs. It's also quite old now and it's two generations behind. The latest microphone from InvenSense is the ICS-43434. Now, there are a couple of boards available from the US, but the shipping costs are quite high, so I've decided to get a few boards manufactured for myself. Now, I've got a few of these boards available, and the schematics and PCB files are also available. Links are in the description. Feel free to use the designs and have your own boards manufactured. If you do get the boards from me, then you'll need to solder on the header pins. Now, I find the best way to solder these kind of boards is to put the header into a breadboard along with some supporting pins to keep the board aligned. I also apply a small amount of flux to help the soldering process. Wiring up the boards is very straightforward. We need 3.3 volts and ground. These boards are not 5 volt tolerant, so do not connect them to the 5 volt rail or you will damage them. We also need the word select clock. This is also known as the LR clock. We need the serial data and we need the serial clock. I've shown the equivalent setup for the ESP32 in the box for this wiring setup. Sample code for this is also in the GitHub link in the description. Let's have a listen to some of the audio. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. So quality seems really good and it's very low noise. Now, for those of you interested in looking under the hood, I also recorded the PCB design process. Now, the actual circuit is pretty simple. We need a connector, and obviously we need the actual microphone. There's a decoupling capacitor between VDD and ground, and there's a pull-down resistor on the serial data line. That's all you need circuit-wise. Laying out the PCB is pretty straightforward. The only slightly tricky part is routing the VDD line. I wanted to keep ground and VDD together on the connector to make it logical, which means I need to route the VDD slightly around the houses. I also wanted to keep all the traces on one side of the board. So with all the traces routed, we can add the board layout and add a couple of screw holes. We'll also add a ground port to both sides of the board and a couple of vias to link the sides together. Now with the layout completed, we just need to add some nice labeling. The microphone is bottom ported, so all the labels will be on the bottom side of the board, which from a user's point of view will be the top side of the board. With that done, we just export the Gerber, BOM and pick and place files and send it off to PCBWay for manufacture and assembly. PCBWay dealt with all the panelling and component sourcing, and within a few weeks a box has arrived. It's all nicely packaged up in individual anti-static bags. They've even given me the leftover components, so I've got a bunch of capacitors and resistors, and there's one leftover microphone. If anyone fancies trying to solder this, they are more than welcome to it. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed this video. I'm still working on another big project, and I hope to finish it soon.